It's time for the Trading Stocks Made Easy podcast. Each week, Trading Stocks Made Easy demystifies stock trading and investing so you can profit big. And now, here's the host of Trading Stocks Made Easy, the wealthy investor, Tyrone Jackson.
Hey, it's Tyrone Jackson. Welcome back to another fabulous episode of Trading Stocks Made Easy in your ear. Thank you for joining me. I want to talk about one of my favorite subjects today, which is called volatility trading. And so many of you really love volatility trading. Now, for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, volatility trading is when we buy certain shares of certain stocks, we wait for the stock price to go up $1, and then we quickly sell them. Now, this is a little bit different than day trading, where day traders are putting a lot of money in a stock and waiting for it to go up 25 cents, and then they sell their shares and they make a profit. When you're volatility trading, you are buying a stock whose price is rapidly moving. Now, what makes a stock's price rapidly move a dollar or two per day? A lot of people think it's them. Hey, Tyrone, I've done my analytics. I realize that this stock has inherent volatility. I want to be in and out of this stock at least once a day. There's nothing wrong with that, except one of the things about volatility trading you have to know is that you and I really don't cause the volatility in the market. Who causes volatility in the marketplace? Well, it's caused by, yet again, the big money. And when I say the big money, I'm talking about insurance companies, banks, college endowments that are buying shares in the millions. So when XYZ insurance company buys 2 million shares of the stock at, let's say, $61, that is going to cause the stock price to go up. Now, as part of your financial education, here's what you should know. That most of today's trading, I read an estimate recently from an exchange, 80% of today's trades are done by software. So sometimes traders like you and I believe that we're really trading against another person actually trading these big block shares. It's really software or something called algorithms, or on Wall Street, we call it algos, right? Believe it or not, there are people who buy programs that are designed to buy and sell stocks to create volatility, and other traders can benefit from them. So today, there's an awful lot of algorithmic trading that goes on a daily basis. So if I'm trying to buy a stock at 60 and sell it at 61, or 61 and sell it at 62, I need to know where volatility is that day, what stocks are the algorithms attracted to. Okay. Remember, trading is a skill, right? So if I understand what stocks the algorithms are attracted to, and I combine that with fundamentals, which means I'm really paying attention to the company's earnings, I'm in a perfect trading situation. So I always like to say we only trade stocks that are in strong upward trends, right? They're in strong upward trends because another group of algorithms keep buying those shares. I'm laughing only because there's a whole system here. But what causes an upward trend? We know fundamentals, right? But there are other algorithms that are buying in predictable intervals, every $7, every $11. And that's also feeding the volatility, but it's also feeding the long-term trend, which, of course, as you know by now, is caused by the top-line revenue growth, right? Okay, so if you and I are really trying to master volatility trades, then we need to be dissecting what causes volatility and what stocks are the most volatile. So if I'm here to help you, let me let you in on a little game. The most volatile stocks in the stock market is in the pharmaceutical sector. In the pharmaceutical sector, they're like the exception to the rules. I never trade pharmaceuticals because, generally speaking, the volatility is way too high and it's not predictable. What causes pharmaceutical stocks to be highly volatile? Well, the answer is really this: new drugs, right? So when a drug that is in a trial phase is in the final phase of the trial before the FDA can approve that drug, you're going to get an enormous amount of volatility. Why? Presumably, if that drug is approved, let's say in this case, it's an arthritis drug. That company can market that drug around the world and make hundreds of millions of dollars in the first 90 days of the release. So traders know, oh man, I want to trade a company where they're in the final phases of a particular drug, because when that approval is announced, the stock can go from $35 literally to $80 a share and then back down and all over the map. What I have found in pharmaceuticals, which is the reason that I don't trade them, is, you know, that happens, FDA approval happens in cycles, right? So we may have several drugs in the pipeline now, and then in the fall, we have no drugs in the pipeline. So there goes your volatility, right? So trading around an event, in this case, a pharmaceutical company's drugs, causes volatility. That's the first thing. Number two, there's an awful lot of volatility in the tech sector. So companies that are in the cloud business, for example, right, tend to be very volatile. Companies that produce apps, anything that's new in terms of technology, you generally are going to see a lot of volatility in those stocks only if the revenue growth is there to support the stock price going higher. Okay. So let's say you wanted to become an expert in volatility, then you know that you may be attracted to pharmaceuticals, or you may be attracted to tech stocks because they inherently have more volatility in them. Now, here's the bad news, and pay attention to me. Volatility is a two-way street. Even when a stock has very strong fundamentals and it's in a very strong upward trend, it could also drop $20 at the same time. So most people think of volatility is always in their favor, always in an upward trend. No, volatility means that stock can go anywhere in the next 48 hours. So what are we seeing right now in this market right now? Stocks that are in strong upward trend with great earnings volatility, and then tomorrow they could be down $25. Even though you were in that stock for a $1 uptick, it can reverse very quickly. Why? Well, something that affects volatility in the market and the algorithms trade on this is the Federal Reserve. Now, here comes your lesson on economics that's immediately tied to trading. The Federal Reserve is a separate body outside of the U.S. government that, in effect, is in charge of the economic homeostasis, if you will, of the economy. And what that basically means is they're there to not only manage the economy as a whole, economically, but also to manage liquidity and cash flow, and interest rates are a tool in which they use to help regulate the economy. So whenever I'm teaching live, I always say to people, we want an economy that is not too hot, not too cold, but just right, like Goldilocks and the Three Bears, right? And that's ultimately what the Fed is supposed to be doing. So on days that the Fed chairman speaks either to Congress or to the public, a lot of volatility, and that's why we get some sell-off some days, even though you're holding a stock that's in an upward trend, because the Fed chairman actually spoke, Wall Street didn't like what he or she had to say, and algorithms sold off the stock. I know a number of you listening to the show have made money off of volatility, but you're not paying attention to the external forces that feed or force volatility. So I know not to put on any trades before the Fed chairman speaks, right? If I'm in a stock that's in an upward direction, because unless that Fed chairman says something that is extremely beneficial to the economy, stocks are not going to go up the day of the address and the day after. Okay? So you got to remember, news in the stock market plays out in 72 hours. So if the Fed chairman said something the market didn't like, probably the next 72 hours, you're not going to see the volatility that you like. So if we're talking about perfecting volatility, you have to be aware of these patterns, okay? Next, I want to talk to you about another key to mastering or perfecting volatility is understanding bid-ask spreads on stocks. Some people don't believe that bid-ask spreads actually exist, but they do. The higher the volatility, the wider the bid-ask spread. So let me explain this to you. When a stock is actually on the market, when you buy a stock, you buy at the asking price. When you sell a stock, you sell at the bid price. There's usually a difference between the ask and the bid. That difference can be, I've seen them as high as a nickel. If you're an options trader, you know what I'm talking about. On the stock side, it's the same thing. So when some people are volatility trading, they try to get their trades placed in between the bid and the ask. Now, personally, I don't like that strategy because you're letting the market maker determine where you get the stock and they don't have to take the price that you offer out there. I always buy at the ask and I always sell at the bid, whatever the market price is. By the way, the person who makes the money between the bid and the ask price is called the market maker. You never see them. So I think, for whatever it's worth, trying to place your bids in the middle of the bid-ask spread and tempt the market maker is a waste of time. It causes you to stare at the screen and go, come on, guys, take that bid, take that bid, take that offer in the middle of the bid-ask spread, and the stock can move a dollar or 50 cents during that time. So my one rule of advice, and I know some of you will disagree on this, is don't try to get your stock purchases filled in between the bid and the ask, because you're going to spend too much energy and time trying to figure out when to get in the stock as opposed to getting in it and having the software sell the stock automatically, which is what I teach you how to do. More on volatility trading right after this.
Want to increase your stock market trading profits? Then you need to start your monthly membership to WITradeschool.com right now. Don't understand how to write covered calls for monthly income? No problem. Simply review Tyrone's latest stock trades in our video library as many times as you need. WITradeschool.com is all about helping you get the financial education you need to earn money in the stock market and change your financial life. Tyrone Jackson, the wealthy investor, has helped his students earn thousands of dollars per month trading stocks online from home. These are people just like you. So what are you waiting for? Follow Tyrone Jackson's red-hot stock trades and investment strategies today. Don't wait. Start your monthly membership at WITradeschool.com right now.
And welcome back. Yes, if you haven't started your membership at WI Trade School, I don't know what you're waiting for. I go over volatility trading many times a month. I show you what stocks are hot right now. And if you like them and you want to engage in that trade, great. So if you're really about learning about volatility, join me at WI Trade School. I'd love to have you there and be able to answer your questions. The drawback of doing this show is that I can't get to your questions, so I rely on Trade School for that. Let's get back to volatility trading. We were talking about in the first half of the show the idea of what is volatility, how does it work, why there's so much volatility in the pharmaceutical sector, and why there's constant volatility in the tech sector. I also talked to you before the break about this idea of the bid-ask spread, and don't try to play the bid-ask spread. It makes you feel good, but you're just trying to tempt the market maker, and very often they won't take your offer. So I like buying at market and selling at market. What is another factor that causes volatility? All right, you ready? This one is called the float size. Now, most of you know what the float is. If you've listened to the show before and you've heard some of my guests talk about it, the float are the amount of shares that are issued that are outstanding that the public can get their hands on. So when a company goes public, there's some shares, right, that the company reserves for themselves. People get stock options, so on and so forth. And then there's another set of shares that the public, people like you and I, retail investors, can get our hands on. Well, those shares that we can get our hands on are called the float. The smaller the float, the larger the volatility. Did you know that? Most people don't realize that. Because if you look at a company that has a billion shares and the public can get their hands on a billion shares, I would expect there to be low volatility there. But because that's a large float. But if we have a company that has 420 shares in the float, that stock price is easily influenced when the algos get in and they start trading the stock, and then you and I benefit from that, okay? So remember, float size is a factor. So we're looking at stocks in a strong upward trend with revenue growth on an annual and quarterly basis, and then that float size plays an important part, but don't volatility trade when the Fed is about to speak. It's not going to happen. So the other thing about volatility trading, buying 1,000 shares, waiting a stock to go up for a dollar, you get triggered out if you use an automated sell order and you make $1,000. Can you do that several times a week? Of course you can. But volatility trading is also very addictive and it inspires greed. So remember, when you're at home trading and you're seeking to make $5,000, $10,000 a week off of volatility trading, you can get very addicted to it and break discipline because you think that your trading is really revolving around you and it's really revolving around institutions, algorithms, and trends that are outside of your control. So when you get used to that, then you're able to really flow with the market as opposed to saying, today has to be a $1,000 day. I see a lot of people trying to force their will on a stock, and this game just doesn't work that way. You have to understand float size, algorithms, and institutional involvement, and buy signals, which I teach you in trade school, of when to buy the stock on certain days at certain times during the day, and then you'll find that you'll be much more successful as a volatility trader. Now, I know that this episode's about volatility trading, but I do want to make one point. The greater the volatility, the higher the call option premiums, because high volatility causes call option premiums to rise. So, if I am a volatility trader, I have to be by default a covered call writer because if my volatility trades aren't firing or executing within 5 days, I could easily sell a covered call taking guaranteed money from the market. That call expires in 5 days. Boom, I'm back to volatility trading. So to be successful in the stock market is not only about your mindset, but it's also about getting the financial education. So when fast, sexy trades like volatility trading are in vogue, you are there. When the market slows down or your favorite stock pulls back, you become a covered call writer. No matter what happens, you're always pulling money into your account. Now, if you don't understand anything I've talked about in this episode, that's okay. That's why you get a financial education. But here's what I want you to know. All of the money that you will generate in your lifetime is based on your beliefs about what is possible. So is it possible to earn $1,000 a week volatility trading? The answer is yes. If it's possible to earn $1,000 a week volatility trading and you had a larger account, is it possible to earn $5,000 a week? The answer is yes. 5, 10, 15, 20, that's $20,000 a month if you learn how to flow with the market and take profits at opportune times. It's not magic. $20,000 a month can be yours. It can be predictable. It can be a predictable revenue stream for you in your life, but you must get the financial education to learn how to flow with the market. Is it possible to earn $11,000 a week? Yes. Again, when you learn to flow with the market, and use volatility trading and cover call writing at the same time. So now you see why I'm always so excited, and I thank you for listening to the episodes of the show, because the world of trading is vast. The key is to get the right financial education, and let me explain it to you in ways that are very, very simple so that you can be successful. There's complexity in everything. You know that, and I know that. But what I love about what I do and what I love about my partnership with you is I get to break down each and every element so that you can understand it, so that you can be successful. You see, when I do this show, I have no vested interest in you thinking that I'm smart. That's just not what I do. I do have a vested interest in you understanding the stock market, how exciting it is, how it can change your life, and how you can take advantage of this right now by getting the right education. Hey, that's going to do it for me. This episode's all about perfecting our skills, volatility, and what are the dynamics that affect volatility so you can profit from it in the market. Tyrone Jackson, the Wealthy Investor, saying, remember, your wealth is in your thinking. Change your money beliefs and your life will change. I'll see you next time.
You've been listening to the Trading Stocks Made Easy podcast. Be sure to rate and review our show on iTunes. While you're on iTunes, be sure to click the subscribe button and you'll automatically receive our next episode.